Welcome back, friends. Welcome to another tutorial from Just Biology. In this lecture, we'll be discussing bacterial genome isolation. So, previous lecture, we have talked about genomic DNA isolation from various samples. In this lecture, covering bacterial genome isolation in detail. As far as the concern to the bacterial genome isolation, we have five different steps, in out of which we have culturing and harvesting of the cell is the first step. The second step is preparation of cell extract. Third step is purification of DNA from RNA as well as the protein. The fifth step, and that is final step, is confirmation of DNA by agarose gel electrophoresis. So let's begin with first step, that is culturing and harvesting of the cell. So we know we have different methods of bacterial cultivation. So out of which one is convenient for us is we have to decide. For that, we need to culture the cells. How we can culture the cell is, we can go for shake flask method. Shake flask method is nothing but, so we can culture or we can inoculate the media in a broth. So broth will give the cells. So what kind of media we can use here is, we can use LB media. So LB media is normally used for overnight culture, that is 12 hours culture. So we need only the overnight culture for bacterial cells. We can perform inoculation and then incubation. So after the incubation, you will get the cells. So how do we get the cells? The method is the harvesting. The harvesting is normally employed by centrifugation. How we can do the centrifugation? So you need to collect the broth in a tube, then that tube is placed in centrifuge and just start the centrifuge. The speed should be maintained or speed should be a specific. You need to set 8000 RPM to 10,000 RPM. So this is a normal range of centrifugal force. Once you did the centrifugation, you will get two things. So what are the things? The first thing you will get it is supernatant. Supernatant. The second thing is a pellet. So what do you mean by supernatant and the pellet? So if you have the media, so media will consist of both solid as well as the liquid part. The liquid part that consisting of the material is called as supernatant, and the solid part which is comprises from the media is called as pellet. The, of course, the cell will be settled as a pellet because that has the density. So the centrifugation is oftenly used density gradient separation. So the cell will be settled at the bottom. So we can easily collect the cells from the tube. So this is the first step of bacterial genome isolation. Let's move on to the next step. The second step of bacterial genome isolation is preparation of cell extract. So we'll focus on cell extract. Cell extract means the chemical which we will add to the cells for breaking the cells. And the cell suspension along with this chemical is called as cell extract. How do you make the cell extract? That we will see first. The first chemical which we should add is, this is not a chemical, actually this is called as an enzyme. So lysozyme is the first one. Second one is SDS or SLS, along with a chelating agent is called as EDTA. So we'll focus on lysozyme followed by SDS, then EDTA. Lysozyme, what is the function of lysozyme is, the lysozyme will break the cell wall. So if we break the cell wall, we can easily access the cell membrane of the bacterial cell. If you add this SDS to the bacterial cell, SDS will break the cell membrane. Once you did the breakage of cell membrane along with the EDTA, the function of EDTA is, it will chelate the magnesium ion which is abide with cell membrane. The magnesium ion will give the rigidity of the cell membrane. If we chelate magnesium ion, all the magnesium ions from the cell membrane. So what will happen? The SDS can easily access to the cell membrane. So we can easily get the DNA from the cells. So this is the second step of bacterial genome isolation. If you added all these chemicals, we should go for again centrifugation. Why? Because we need to remove all the cell waste or contaminants from cells. We need to remove all this stuff. So again, you should go for a centrifugation with the RPM of 8,000 to 10,000 RPM. So this is normally we used to follow. Then after the centrifugation, you will get the raw DNA or along with RNA as well as the protein. We need to remove this protein from that DNA mixture, RNA as well. How we can remove that protein as well as the RNA from the DNA? So that would be the next step of DNA isolation. The third step of bacterial genome isolation is purification of DNA from RNA as well as the protein. How we can perform this purification? We can go for two methods. The first method which we should follow is phenolistic chloroform mixture addition. The phenolistic chloroform mixture will precipitate protein as well as the RNA from the DNA mixture. So if we did the centrifugation once more, we can remove RNA as well as the protein from the DNA mixture. But this method is not convenient because you may expect contamination or the small amount of RNA or protein in the same mixture. The second method is more specific, and rather than specific, they are more like costly. So that method is enzymatic method. In enzymatic method, we have several kind of enzymes based on the substrate. The substrate means RNA or protein. If you want to remove RNA from the DNA mixture, you need to treat that mixture with RNA degrading enzyme. So RNA degrading enzyme is the best non-enzyme is RNase H. Best degrading enzyme is RNase H. The same way you can use protein degrading enzyme for removal of the protein. What sort of enzyme you can use? The proteinase enzyme you can use. So there are many specific enzymes which is used for removal of protein. Here you can use proteinase K as your degrading enzyme. So after adding all the chemicals or this enzyme to this DNA mixture, again you should go for centrifugation with the same RPM which I mentioned earlier. So this is the third step of bacterial genome isolation. Let's move on to the next step. The fourth step of bacterial genome isolation is the concentration of DNA. In order to concentrate that DNA, we need to add something to it for the concentration. We need to put all the DNA together. For that, we need to add some chemical or we should follow some method. For that, we can use ice cold ethanol for precipitation or the spooling of DNA. So once you add this ice cold ethanol, the ethanol will precipitate the DNA in refrigeration temperature, that is nearly 4 degrees Celsius. Nearly 4 degrees Celsius is most preferable temperature for the precipitation of DNA. So if you finish this step of precipitation, the final step that is the storage of DNA. That as we all know, the DNA is not stable for a longer time. In order to store the DNA, we need to put the DNA in buffer. That buffer is known as TE buffer. The TE means the trace EDTA buffer, which stabilizes the DNA for a longer time. So this is the idea of the storing of DNA. So let's move on to the final step, that is most prominent step, most prominent and the most important step in genome isolation. So once you've got the DNA, how can we know that is DNA or that is so we can differentiate whether it is contaminated or not. So that for that purpose, we need to go for a specific technique is called as agarose gel electrophoresis. Agarose gel electrophoresis by which we can predict the DNA is in pure or not. So you will get the different kinds of bands with a stain is called as ethidium bromide. So this stain will give you the bands of DNA which we can identify whether they have contaminated or not. So this is the basic idea of bacterial genome isolation in laboratory method. And if you like the video, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe and click the bell icon for latest updates. And keep watching and stay tuned, guys. Thank you for watching.